Rogers, born and bred. Bernie and Sid in the morning.
Bernard McGurk and Sid Rosenberg.
Making mischief their business. 77 WABC and the WABC radio app.
The waiting is over! The New York Rangers are the Stanley Cup champions! And this one will last a lifetime!
Oh, that's one of the great calls of all time. Marv Albert, Rangers, 1994, 25 years already. That unbelievable playoff run. Mateau, of course. Sam Rosen is here. That was Sam Rosen. Stephane Mateau, of course. That big effort, the Howie Rose call. Mateau, Mateau, Mateau. And how ironic would it be that Howie would go on to the Islanders announcing after that. But, you know, I wrote my book, You're Wrong and You're Ugly, which most of you didn't read. And never will. That's fine, though. Bernie wrote a great chapter. I wrote in my book that of all the teams I love, and I went to the Mets parade when they won it in 86. I went to the Giants up when they won it. The one season in my 52 years on Earth that I enjoyed most and the one parade I enjoyed most was the Rangers. They've gone over 50 years, and, you know, they started bringing in all these guys from Edmonton, the Mark Messiers, and at one point you had Glenn Anderson and Jeff Bookaboom and Kevin Lowe and all these, McTavish. And to win the Cup was just, in my lifetime, it's my favorite win of any local team. Anyway, later on tonight at Carlton, at the Carlton Eisenhower in the Park, my dear friend Mike Cave. Mike Cave does a terrific job with his charity, Pink Tie. They have a couple of huge events every single year raising money for breast cancer. Tonight, Stony Brook Children's Hospital. And he's put together a list of unbelievable celebrities and stars from New York here. Yankees like Bernie Williams, Jim Leyritz, and Cecil Fielder. You got Wesley Walker, the former great Jet. John Starks, the former great Knickerbocker. And a couple of all-time Ranger greats in Ron Duguay and Mike Richter. And, of course, Richter was the goalie on that team that won the Cup 25 years ago. And here he is on the Bernie and Sid Show in the morning. The great Mike Richter. Mike, good morning, pal. How are you?
Wow. Great. Thanks for having me on. How you been?
We've been great, and we love having you on. I think the last time I had you on, you were doing something with the New York City Marathon, Mike, a couple of years ago. You remember that a couple of years ago with the marathon, you were doing something?
I do. I just finished. It was a tough run.
That's right.
No, I was with the ING Marathon.
That's right.
First and only New York City Marathon. It was awesome. Great event.
Yeah, you did a terrific job. So let's get to the fun stuff with the Rangers before we get to the Mike Cave event tonight. I was sure. Just saying, Mike, that, you know, I waited my whole lifetime. Your win was my favorite. I'm a diehard Met fan, Knick fan, Giant fan. But your Ranger win to this day at 52 years old is my favorite season and win ever. But for me, it feels like 100 years ago. It's 25 years. For you, does it seem like yesterday or a long time ago?
Yeah, a little bit of both. I have to say that 25 years handle is a little tough. When the Ranger officials this year said, hey, we're going to do a couple things. Like in January, we had this 25-year reunion, and we're all excited to do that. These are all friends, they're family, these guys, you know. As they say, you walk together for life. So it was great to see him again. But 25 years, man, that went fast. It's just every time I'm reminded in a different way. But this one hit hard that life goes by quickly.
Hey, Mike Richter, listen, Bernard McGurk here. Look, I was at Game 6. There was nothing more exciting. I know you guys lost. You went on to win, of course. But it was one hell of a run. And I want to question you on this. Do you still hang out with Messier, Brian Leetch, and those guys?
For sure. Like I said, I mean, Mess lives in town. I'm in Connecticut. He's 20 minutes away from me. We see each other a fair amount. The Rangers have been really good about getting alums back, though. I see Stephane Mateau. Of course, Gravy's involved with the administration there. So it does seem like that's home. And, you know, as you go through, we come to New York as young men. Like, that's where you grow up.
Yeah.
I actually was born in Philadelphia, but I've spent my adult life here in New York, and the people behind the scenes, as well as the players you played with, they are your family, your confidants, your friends throughout the years, and they remain so. So, yeah, we do, and the Rangers have been very, very good at not only getting us together, but actually leveraging some of this for some really good charity work. I mean, New York's a tough place, but no place has bigger hearts.
You know, Mike, when I was a kid, I would get in fistfights all the time because when you live in this city, you love one team, you hate the other. So I'd literally get into fistfights. Who's better, Phil Simms or Richard Todd? Who's better, Lee Mazzilli or Bucky Dent? I mean, the dumbest stuff you ever heard. You know, who's better, Ron Duguay or Mike Bossy, which was ridiculous, of course. But anyway, so, but as an adult, I don't do that stuff anymore except for once. Literally 2 years ago, I nearly came to fisticuffs. It was a fight between who's better. You ready for this?
Yeah.
Mike Richter or Henrik Lundqvist. And I was not going to have it. I know Lundqvist has won a lot of big games, a lot of big games. Statistically, he may go down as the best. But I saw Mike Richter win a cup. I saw Mike Richter against Martin Brodeur, USA versus Canada, put on a show. As far as I'm concerned, Eddie Jockman was great. A lot of greats. The greatest ever, Mike Richter.
Well, look, first of all, I don't want to say that I advocate fisticuffs, but this one's worth dropping a glove for, damn it. No, I have to say, look, I'm a friend of Henrik Lundqvist. The consistency, this guy's a beast out there. I love watching him play, and I think Brian Leach said it best. It's very difficult to compare errors. It's one thing to say, hey, Marty Brodeur versus Patrick Waugh while they're playing, but even... I mean, it's been 25 years since we won. It's been 15 years since I played. It is a different game. And to sit there and say who's better is a difficult thing. I think the world of Henrik Lundqvist. I've not seen a better goalie put on pads. I think this kid can play. Obviously, he's just played at such a level of consistency. And I think, you know, one of the real major differences in the NHL, even since I arrived, is how much influence the European game has, and nowhere more than goalies. Look at Tuukka Rask. I mean, the kid's played unbelievable. Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, I love Lunky. You know, Eddie Jockman. How would have Lundqvist or myself played in that generation? It's a different game.
I'll tell you another guy, too, Mike, that actually played for a Stanley Cup of the Rangers. Now, he did lose, but he got to the Cup. He was heroic that year, 1979. John Davidson losing to Montreal. And now Davidson is back with the Rangers in management. What do you think of them bringing back John Davidson?
Well, first, I'd like to say, I mean, I was, you know, John's not that much older than I, but, you know, as a little kid, you might be 14 reading about goaltenders and whatnot, and John's a couple of years older. I remember reading about him and just cutting out pictures of him, put him on our wall, and one of his coaches said, wow, never stop till you're the best. And I didn't realize how good John Davidson was. I think a lot of people, you know, quickly miss because he has such a big personality in the radio and he's done such good things as an administrator. He was an unreal goalie, the top-ranked goalie in Canada, and played, obviously, amazing for the Rangers. But, you know, it's just a shame. We'd be talking about him, as far as his goaltending is concerned, a lot more if he weren't for injuries. I mean, he was an amazing player.
You know, Mike Keenan, of course, the coach, Mike Richter, of the Rangers in 94. And the man who brought Mike Keenan to the Rangers was a guy named, a friend of mine, Bob Gutkowski, both of those guys. How instrumental were both of them?
Bob Gutkowski is one of the best human beings around.
Yes, he is.
Just first class. I've spoken to him since. I mean, he was just one of those guys that had such an even keel about him. You know, look, it's an emotional game. There were different personalities. He and JD, by the way, held that team together. When, look, there was rifts between Neil and Mike and good visions from both, but competing directions for the team, and that got ugly. And it could, if it weren't for strong personalities and people who know how to manage people. Forget the hockey for a second. You got to manage people in all these endeavors, right? You know, what's going on in the locker room with St. Louis? They just got smoked last night. You know, how did Boston react when they lost two in a row and coming into last night? You have to manage people. And these guys were phenomenal leaders in that regard and kept the ship straight. And you see the results.
No doubt, Mike Richter, amazing Ranger between 1989 and 2003, 14 years providing thrills right downstairs. You actually do the show, Mike, every morning, 17th floor, 2 Penn Plaza, right above Madison Square Garden. We see Adam Graves all the time. So we are in it still, for you guys, 25 years later. So tell me about this event. I'm very, very good friends with Mike Cave. I see Mike all the time, and his pink tie events are always spectacular. This one tonight, which will raise money to help the Stony Brook Children's Hospital at the Carlton in Eisenhower Park, seems to be as star-studded as anyone he's ever done. What about this effort tonight?
Look, I mean, he and his brother Rich started this, 7 years ago, and they've raised millions of dollars for charity. And, you know, I was saying New York's a tough place, but this is the type of person you run into. And I know some of the younger guys that I came to were scared to come to the city and whatnot. and you run into guys like you, you run into guys like JD, you run into guys like the Cave Brothers, they know what they're doing, and they're giving back. So, yeah, millions of dollars to date. And, you know, when you're asked to do these things, I was going to go this one last year. I was out of town, so I'm excited. This is my first, and I kind of can't wait to do it. A little bit, I'm digging for a pink tie right now, so I got to.
Hey, Mike Richter, I got to tell you, it's an honor and a pleasure to speak to you. The goalie of the championship 1994 New York Rangers, really a pleasure, and you're a great guy. Thank you.
Thanks for having me, yeah, and support this charity. It's awesome.
Yes, we will. Pink Tie. Just go to pinktie.org. And again, I'll be there tonight with Mike and Ron Duguay, a couple of former Ranger greats, as well as many other celebrities, but important people too. People donating and raising money for both breast cancer and the Stony Brook Children's Hospital. Mike Richter continues to be an influential part of New York City, even 25 years after winning the big prize. Still to come, Joe Tacopina, Rich Valdez, and the Blitz, Mets and Yankees later on tonight. We'll be right back.